So in order to understand chair conformations, we have to understand that there's two different types of positions that chairs have. So I want to just go ahead and just draw these out, and hopefully this will make sense to you guys. The first and the easiest positions to visualize are what's called the axial positions. Okay? The axial positions are going to follow... Oops, that's not follow. Follow each corner. Okay? So what that means is that if your corner is facing up, then your axial position is going to face straight up. Okay? So you can see that this corner was kind of facing a little bit on the upside. Okay? What about this corner? What direction is that one facing? Actually, it's facing kind of up because I have one that's going slightly up, slightly up. So I would expect my axial position to go straight up from here. How about this one? That one, both of them are going down, so I would expect my axial to go down. And if you draw in all your axial positions, they're going to look like this. Okay? The axial positions are always the easiest ones to draw, and you should always start off drawing the axial positions. Okay? Are you guys cool with that so far? They follow each corner. Now, the equatorial ones are the tricky ones, and they're the ones that, if you're like a dude and you can't draw, these are the ones that are going to mess you up on the test. All right? So you're going to have to be extra careful. Just already know, you have like multiple risk factors for getting this question wrong if you're like a guy and you can't draw. So you have to be extra careful. Equatorial, and I'm just going to say right now, I am one of those people, so I have to be very careful. So equatorial is going to be, what I'm going to say is it's going to be slightly opposite to the direction of the axial, of each axial. Okay? So what that means is imagine that each of these corners have two H's, right? So some of the H's are going to be on the axial positions. Each position has one axial. Each carbon has one axial. Each carbon also has one equatorial. The equatorial positions are going to face slightly opposite to the axial. So that means, notice this one right here. That one is facing up, right? That axial. That means that my equatorial position should face slightly down. Okay? So that means this H, the equatorial one, would face slightly down. Now let's look at this one. This one is facing down, so that means that my equatorial position should face slightly up. Is that cool? And we would do the same thing for all of these. So then this one, my equatorial position would go slightly up. This one, my equatorial position would go slightly down. And like that, and like that. Okay? Now you might be wondering, why is it so important to draw these slightly down and slightly up? The reason is because I already made this huge point about how cyclohexane has no ring strain, right? I already kept telling you guys that. No ring strain means that the bond angles must be around 109.5, right? That means that you need all of these hydrogens to be 109.5 degrees away from each other, okay? So for example, if you draw your hydrogen, let's say you draw your hydrogen like this, okay? Is that right? No, because if you look at that bond angle is going to be much less than 109.5. That's going to be wrong, okay? So you need to make sure that you're always protecting that 109.5 bond angle in every single corner. On top of that, I'm not just being nitpicky. This is actually going to be the difference between you getting the question right or wrong once you start getting into cis and trans, because cis and trans is based off of these bonds, okay? These bond angles. So it's really, really important that you don't let yourself get lazy. And it's really important that you save yourself the headache and just start drawing them right from the very beginning. So that would be a much better H to draw. Okay? So now that you guys understand the two different types of positions, let's go ahead and go on to the next video.